Good morning. For the children's time today, we're going to read a story together. Have you filled your bucket today? All day long, everyone in the whole wide world walks around carrying an invisible bucket. There's a lot of people in the world. You can't see it, but it's there. You have a bucket. Your mom and dad have a bucket. Your sister and brother have a bucket. Your grandparents, friends, and neighbors all have a bucket. Everyone carries an invisible bucket. Your bucket has one purpose only. Its purpose is to hold your good thoughts and good feelings about yourself. You feel very happy and good when your bucket is full. And when you feel sad and lonely, your bucket is empty. Other people feel that same way too. They're happy when their buckets are full, and they're sad when their buckets are empty. It's great to have a full bucket, and this is how it works. You need each other, and you need other people to fill your bucket, and other people need you to fill theirs. So how do you fill a bucket? You fill a bucket when you show love to someone. When you say or do something kind, or even when you give someone a smile, that's being a bucket filler. A bucket filler is a loving, caring person who says or does nice things that make others feel special. And when you make someone feel special, you're filling a bucket. But you can also dip into a bucket and take some out of the good feelings. You dip into a bucket when you want to make fun of someone. When you say or do mean things, or even when you ignore someone, that's being a bucket dipper. A bully is a bucket dipper. A bucket dipper says or does mean things that make others feel bad. Many bucket dippers have an empty bucket. They think they can fill their own bucket by dipping into someone else's, but that will never work. You'll never fill your own bucket when you dip into someone else's. But guess what? When you fill someone's bucket, you fill your own bucket too. You feel good when you help others feel good. All day long, we're either filling up or dipping into each other's buckets by what we say and what we do. Try to fill a bucket and see what happens. You love your mom and dad. Why not tell them you love them? You can even tell them why. Your caring words will fill their buckets right up. Watch for smiles to light up on their faces. You'll feel like smiling too. A smile is a good clue that you have filled a bucket. If you practice, you'll become a great bucket filler. Just remember that everyone carries an invisible bucket, and think of what you can say or do to fill it. Here are some ideas for you. You could smile and say hi to the bus driver. He has a bucket too. You could invite the new kid at school to play with you or Zoom with you. You could write a thank you note to your teacher. You could tell your grandpa that you'd like to spend time with him. There are many ways to fill a bucket. Bucket filling is fun and easy to do. It doesn't matter how young or old you are. It doesn't cost money. It doesn't take much time. And remember, when you fill someone else's bucket, you will fill your own bucket too. When you're a bucket filler, you will make your home, your school, and your neighborhood better places to be. Bucket filling makes everyone feel great. So why not decide to be a bucket filler today and every day? Just start each day by saying to yourself, I'm going to do something to fill someone's bucket today. And at the end of each day, ask yourself, did I fill a bucket today? Yes, I did. That's the life of a bucket filler. And that is you. So I like this story because it reminds me of what Jesus calls us to do, to love one another and to care for one another. God bless. See you next week.